Shalom, it's Tazadaq. Once again, Yananda sounds like the voice of Tazadaq. And we're here today on Universal Indigenous TV 7. And we're going to be interviewing Victoria. And we're actually in Norfolk, Virginia, off of Hampton Boulevard. Because she's going to get her input on a few things here about, you know, how we as so-called black people are actually thriving in the world today, our interactions amongst each other, and the recent shooting in Norfolk, Virginia. So without further delay, LSC and Victoria is going to come up and we're going to interview her. So, I mean, if you would, can you both interview actually introduce yourselves, like just giving your first name or something?
I'm El Sheba Bay, and this is Victoria.
All right. So you can go ahead.
Okay. Can you just tell us a little bit about...
Speak a little louder so you're coming to mic.
Okay. Can you tell us a little bit of what you're trying to do for your community?
Well, I feel like we need to empower the youth so that the next generation will be stronger than we are now.
Okay. Why do you think you can make a difference?
I believe my spirituality and the testimony I have that I lived through has an impact of my belief, and I feel that it can help others.
Okay. When you said your belief, meaning like your belief in God?
Yes, or? Belief in God. God alone. I feel like that from generations, from my ancestors on, we have been lied to, many of us rooted down in our ancestors, that now we are actually playing it out in our lives today, in our generations. Living in a low income area, I see that a lot of from people my age and my generation are blind. And they raising blind children. And I want to awaken our children. I want to teach them to plant seeds in them so that they can grow, just like someone did.
Okay. Why do you think that the youth are lost and blind? Do you think it starts at the home first? Or you think that they're just picking up things from being out in the streets and, you know, getting advice?
It will start from the home, but much more rooted in our history. For one, our history is not told, the true history. Our history didn't start with slavery. That's not the beginning of our history as black people. I feel like if we educate ourselves first and our children, we will raise up strong black leaders for God.
Right.
Because that's what the problem is. A lot of people and, you know, leaders, they use God for their own agendas. And at the end of the day, it's not helping our people. It's not helping our children. It's just keeping them. They're doing the exact same thing the enemy did. They're lying to us. They are now, it's no longer the enemy that's hurting us. It's ourselves hurting ourselves, our people.
Okay. Now, in this area, this neighborhood, are there a lot of black churches?
It's just one.
Just one. So what do you feel like that one church that's in this neighborhood is doing for the black people?
Well, personally, I don't know. I've been there. I visited there a couple times. You know, it was a small congregation. I did see them do back to school stuff. But speaking on churches all around, and like, I analyze this. In a black community, it's like 1,000 churches on one block. Different churches, this Baptist, that Baptist, this Baptist, that Christian, this Catholic. It's just a lot of churches there. And to my opinion is that they are there to continue to brainwash us. Because if, you know, we know a church is supposed to be the house of God.
Right.
So if the church is the house of God, then why are we not speaking about God and His laws and helping us to practice those laws?
Right.
And keeping the commandments laws. And even practice the fruit of the Spirit, that's very important. These things are being ignored and pushed under the rug for their own, again, agenda.
Okay, so the recent shooting that happened in the Tidewater Gardens area and
Tower Park.
Yeah, the
police,
Park.
Police shooting.
Right. So it just not just that one shooting, but just like the shooting of the black male in general. Like,
well, actually, let me if I intervene for a second, if I may. Now, recently, it wasn't just that one isolated shooting. There was a series of five shootings already this year in Norfolk, Virginia, none in 2015 by police officers that was fatalities. And two was actually within 2 weeks of each other. So what is your view on that? Do you think the police is actually going out of control? Or do you think it's something within the community? Do you think any of these things could be partially racially motivated because black lives don't seem to matter to a lot of so-called white cops? Now, they haven't really disclosed, the race of the cops that actually shot the cop, but I mean the brother, but it was actually two police officers that opened fire on him. And they were aware that this man actually had a history of mental illness. He was a schizophrenic. Now, all of this was actually taken in, it should have been taken into consideration. And with that being said, my question is, why did they not use tasers instead of weapons? So what is your view on that? What do you have to say about that?
Well, first, I'm gonna go deep. The enemy, he's very crafty. And when he sees our people waking up, he's gonna try anything in the world, anything that he has power over, to try to stop what God is trying to do, what God is going to do, because he's going to do it regardless. So I just feel that the enemy is using different, this is just one way. This is just one way of many different ways he's using people. And the enemy uses certain people to attack his God's children. And this has been done for years and many decades and many centuries and you can go like 1400s, how it was always the enemy, it was a religion war, That's why I'm not religious, for one, because that sets division, and it keeps us far from God, because now we are so focused on religion and other man-made laws, the way that religion is supposed to go, whatever, we are far from God. And I feel that, of course, the enemy will use people who's not covered under God to attack his people, because the enemy knows who God's soldiers are. And the sad thing about it, some of us don't know that we are God's soldiers, So we have to go through the tests and trials, tribulations that, just like in Job, he allowed Satan to test Job in his faith.
Right.
And we live that right now. We're living that. And so he'll use our own. And that's what happened. That was just another tactic, another crafty way for the enemy. And some people don't even know the enemy is using it.
Right.
So they are confused, because it's like the blind leading the blind. And I'm not going to sit there and say all churches are bad and all black churches are bad, because they are not. But it is very true that a lot of them know the truth and don't want to speak it. So right. Then what did that say? That they are not trying to work with God, they're working against God, because they're withholding truth for us, from us.
Is there anything that you would like to talk about? Like any other opinions or views you have about anything?
I just feel that we need to wake up. People need to wake up. Especially people with color. I feel that we African Americans are the lost tribe, the tribe of Israel. And history repeats itself.
Right.
So if history repeats itself, when Moses brought the Israelites out of Pharaoh's captivity,
Hold on, because I want to read 2 Kings 14 and 16.
Okay.
Keep going.
It's the same slavery that we're living now, just a modern day. And until we, as people, you know, really profess to God and get back under His covenant, we are not going to be protected by Him. And those who, and I do want to say this, we have people, it's different categories of people. So we have people that's blind and sleep. We have people who is waking up and the devil is still trying to keep them from getting the truth. We have people who just don't care or are awake but don't care and just despite God. We know the enemy has his soldiers. We know that from the beginning. But I do want to say this to those who know the truth and choose not to speak the truth. You can't be covered by God. And then you go against the enemy. You go against the enemy, but you're not covered by God. Like, you're not going to win. And at the end of the day, you just, you know, dig yourself up, your own little hole. So.
Yeah, so, really thank you for that. But, you know, as from my perspective, as far as the shootings and so on and so forth, there's greater evils that's coming. And the reason that our people are actually being murdered by the cops and so on and so forth and their own black people is because of the curse that's actually on our people. And when you read the book of Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, you'll get that understanding. And the curses is on our people because they have not returned to these laws, statutes, and commandments. So get the book of 2nd Idris and the Apocrypha, chapter 14, verse 16, and read what you got right there.
It says that, "For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter."
So a lot of people saying that, oh wow, this is evil. Cops are killing people all over. Michael Brown, you know, all of these other people that died. Sandra, you know, her and everyone else that was died. The man died that was actually selling Lucy cigarettes in New York. But the scriptures say greater evils are going to come because our people won't return to the Lord's statutes and commandments. They'd rather be out at the club. They'd rather be playing Xbox 360. They'd rather be churching skirts. But the scriptures, this is all prophecy. So when you see these people out here dying, it's because they're breaking the Lord's statutes and commandments of the Heavenly Father. And the only thing that's going to save you is returning to these Lord's statutes and commandments. Egyptology is not going to save you. Islam is not going to save you. You know, being a Moor is not going to save you. All of these other philosophies has actually failed you. You know, our people has actually preached this pro-black stuff for years. Malcolm X, Marcus Garvey, Louis Farrakhan. None of that has actually saved our people. The only one that's going to save our people is the Creator. And he's a so-called black man when you read the scriptures and get understanding. Revelations 1 and 13 through 15. So unless you return to these laws, statutes, and commandments, the Heavenly Father is going to continue to destroy you and your families. What else you got? You have anything else?
You got any other questions? Because I'm
on the road. Yeah, so I got some questions.
Good.
I got them off of the top of my head. So, you know, since our first teachers, you know, are women, you know, I think it's imperative that sisters actually return to the Lord's statutes and commandments of the Heavenly Father because women are our first teachers. So, like, these little black boys that you see that grow up to be delinquent, if the woman's mind is not right, then the boy is not going to be right. Now, most people say that's the father's responsibility, but let's see. Get the book of Proverbs, chapter 10, verse 1, and let's see what the scriptures say regarding that. Let's see what makes a boy wise, because women are our first educators. So it has been said by many people, if you destroy a man, you destroy an individual, but if you destroy a woman, you destroy a nation. Let's see if the Bible backs that up.
Okay, Proverbs 1 says...
No, Proverbs 10.
10 and 1.
Verse 1.
The proverb of Solomon, a wise son maketh a glad father.
So if a son grows up to be wise, then his father is glad. His father is happy. Read.
But a foolish son is the heaviness of his mother.
So if a son turns out to be a fool, he's a delinquent, he gets caught up into all these nonsense that's out here, it's because it's the heaviness of his mother, because his mother didn't teach him right from the crib. So it has to start at an early age. Now, in this modernized society, you got the woman that's actually out working just like the man, so no one's actually raising the children. There's no one raising the children. They're either raising themselves or they're being raised by some babysitter or some daycare that don't really care about them. So do you think that there's something that sisters could actually do to actually improve the situation for our people? And if so, then what?
I feel that we need to first find ourselves. We need to find God. We need to pray to Him and build up our spiritual strength. And then, you know, like you said, we are teachers. Mm-hmm. So not only our child, but we will take care of our home first. Mm-hmm. Then we go out and teach others, because not everybody, every mother is going to feel the way you feel. That is afraid because they wasn't taught.
Right.
So they're afraid to face their fears. And, you know, this is the problem. Mm-hmm. You know, and then, you know, you have different religions saying that women don't not supposed to preach.
Right.
So that's another sign from the enemy to trick us, to keep us in this bondage, you know. So.
Mm. No. He edited the video, so if we don't.
Whew, you edited the video? Thank you.
So, what's the?
Oh, the scripture about the women are to be silent in the.
1 Timothy's. Get 1 Timothy's 2, verse 9 and 10. Now, women can teach. Women are supposed to teach other women and children, like we was just bringing out.
Right.
But if you notice, there was prophecies in the Bible, and you know, there was a time that the Israelites' men were so off that the Heavenly Father used a prophetess to actually talk to the men to go out and teach. So the message came through the woman, and she translated it to the men, and they went out and teach.
Right.
Because it's supposed to be the men out front.
Right. Right.
First
that,
Timothy.
That is not happening. I see that now.
No, that's not happening.
And they're not even letting the women to come to them with something from God.
Because there's a lot of pride. There's a lot of pride. And you know, that's going to send a lot of people astray. You know,
And I'm seeing that now.
Yeah. And so there's a lot of leaders that's actually causing our people to go off and go astray.
Right.
You know, but still our people continue to follow these leaders, these foolish leaders.
Well, and I agree with that. And that's why I say you just listen to them, because he can only hide his true self for so long, because God is the truth.
Right.
So when you are not speaking for God and you're lying, and it's going to come out. So, and it's going to come out with his own words. He's going to speak the truth that he's lying.
First Timothy 2:12. But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to exert authority over the man.
So, let's stop right there. So it's not saying that a woman can't teach. It's saying that she's not supposed to be teaching and usurping authority over men. Now, some people take that and they'll just go like, well, my wife can't teach me nothing. That's not what that's saying. Because sometimes the Most High comes to the woman. Like, when he was dealing with Isaac and Rebekah, he dealt with Rebekah, telling her that there's two children in your womb. And the message came to her that Jacob was supposed to receive the blessing and not Esau. So, and she articulated that to her husband. So sometimes the Heavenly Father does talk to the woman, and she translates that message to a man. And sometimes the woman might be in the truth and the man's not. So she may have to actually show him, hey, this is what you're supposed to be doing, and so on and so forth. So don't get that misconstrued. Read.
But to be in silence.
Yeah, to be in silence. Now, this is saying that a woman should not be out in the church and so on and teaching and leading the congregation, because it's not the order. And let's prove that. Get First Corinthians, the 11th chapter, verse 1-3. Because the Heavenly Father he set up a divine order. And the order is the Most High, then Yahweh Shah, then the man, then the woman, then the children. That's the divine order. And when you break that order, you get chaos. Go ahead. In fact, if a woman is with a man and the man is real weak, and he's always doing everything that the woman says, the woman's going to eventually want to leave him. She's not going to respect him. She's going to lose respect for him because he's supposed to be the head. But that doesn't mean like a dictator. Go ahead, read what you got.
1 Corinthians 11 and 3. But I have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
Yeah.
And the head of the woman is man. And the head of Christ is God.
So that's the divine order. When you break that order, you get chaos. So that's what this world is like it is. Because it's chaotic. Because people are out of order. People are doing what they want to do. You got homosexuals and lesbian all over the place.
Yep.
You got people trying to validate like transgenders going into whichever bathroom they want. All of that stuff's against God. Now, how you going to be... Now, America is supposed to be a Judeo-Christian country, right? It says it's set up on Judeo-Christians... concepts. Now, how is this going to be a Christian nation? And the word Christian just means a follower of Christ. That means they're supposed to be following Yahweh Shah or Yeshua, whichever Hebrew language you want to speak it in. So if this nation is following Christ, a homosexual is supposed to be put to death, according to Leviticus 20th chapter, verse 13. But under Christ, He's given an opportunity to repent.
Right.
But you're not supposed to be promoting it,
right,
saying, okay, this is okay. You could do whatever you want to do. So it shows you that this nation is hypocritical.
Right.
So you got something else you want to say, sister?
That's it. I mean, I just really wish people would wake up and, you know, we have more teachers out here to wake us up.
So, I mean, you have any kind of contact information? You may want someone to get in contact with you if they're interested, you know, in learning the truth and so on and so forth, like a sister's congregation. That's probably something that's desperately needed,
yeah,
in this area, you know, like a group of sisters that actually want to get together and study the scriptures and learn the truth. Not to be, you know, like Jezebels or anything like that,
right,
but are sincerely interested in that word of the Heavenly Father and spreading this truth.
Well, I don't have no contact number right now, but it's in progress right now.
But, I mean, you could give them an email address or anything. Or anything.
Sassy V, S-A-S-S-Y-V, as in Victoria, 5324 at gmail.com.
So you can close it up.
Mm-hmm. This has been Ella Sheva Bay. Thank you for tuning in to Universal Indigenous TV 7. Here with the interview with Victoria, and we hope you like the video. Give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family.